Hey friends, do you want to learn a new programming language in the most efficient and fun way possible? If so, I have a solution for you. Learning alone from scratch can be draining. I've tried before with Rust and I haven't gotten far. Rust is a hardcore language. However, I've come across two online services that have helped me along the way. I'm using them, I'm having fun with them. In fact, I'm having difficulty tearing myself away from them. These two websites are complementary because they cover two different stages in the learning journey. They're called Exercism and Codecrafters. I've provided links for both of them in the description. Exercism is for mastering the basics and Codecrafters is for diving deep. Together, they make up a three-stage learning rocket and the final stage being a full project. Now, before I go into what these websites offer, I want to explain why I think they're so good. As you may know, my daughter is currently studying at a school called 42 here in Paris, France. I've explained in more detail in this video what it is, but basically, to be honest, I'm jealous of my daughter because I wish I had the same opportunity as she had. As I've been exploring these two services, I've realized that's exactly why I enjoy them so much. They're built on exactly the same guiding principles. Now, before I show you these two services, I want to explain the principles that set them apart. So here are the seven reasons why I believe they are the ideal way to learn to code and why I'm having so much fun learning with these tools. First, although these are websites, you do the work locally on your computer in your preferred code editor. This has several advantages. It makes for a smoother experience, it helps you get set up with your work environment, it means that the challenges can go into a lot more depth, and of course the code editor has a lot fewer distractions than the browser. Now, second reason, the challenges are graded using unit tests that you can run locally. This means that you can iterate on your code and see what's needed to do to reach the goal before submitting it for grading. Third, the challenges are guided, but they don't hold your hand. In one Rust challenge, I had to reverse a string. Sounds simple, right? Well, I got stuck into how Rust manages type constraints and mutability. I dived into the documentation to understand what was going wrong. And let me tell you, that lesson stuck. There's a big difference between learning in theory and learning in practice. Fourth, the challenges are progressive. They provide structured learning. They build on each other. You start by setting up basic functionality and then you refine and you build up. In both cases, for both services, each step builds on the previous one. Fifth, the learning is community-driven. You can share your roadblocks. You can help others by reviewing their code. And as I've learned from building this channel, you learn a lot more when you explain. Sixth, the experience is gamified, giving you visible goals and a clear vision of where you are and how much work lies ahead. Seventh, both services provide self-paced learning. You can take things as slow or as fast as you like, although of course you need to work regularly at it for your learning journey to be effective. So just to recap, here are the seven reasons why I'm having so much fun with the challenges in these services. You work locally, they're graded with unit tests, they're guided, but they don't hold your hand, they're progressive, they build on one another, they're community driven, you can learn with your peers, they're gamified and they're self-paced. Now, cool bonus things about both these services is they provide the same exercise in different languages. So once you've mastered the logic in one language, it's easy to progress in the others. So you can go through a track in one language that you're familiar with, and then you can switch to a new one. Now that we've covered what these services have in common, let's look at what they each offer specifically. As I've said before, Codecrafters is for diving deep, but Exercism is for the fundamental basics. So let's start with that. Exercism is a platform that helps you learn the basics of various programming languages by completing exercises, hence their name. They support over 65 languages with classics such as Python, C, Rust, PHP, Java, TypeScript, JavaScript, and Go, and more niche languages such as Haskell, Lua, Nim, and some I never even heard of before, like Gleam and Ballerina and Groovy. Each language is a track and starts with a simple Hello World exercise. From then on, the track is more or less elaborate, and I've seen kind of three tiers of features for the languages. First, for the least supported languages, you run the unit tests locally, and the system trusts you to mark your exercises as complete once you've submitted them. It suggests other exercises based on what you've completed. Now, this is the case for Dart, for example. In the next tier, the tier above, Exorcism validates your code server-side and can sometimes provide automated feedback provided by AI. The server-side validation allows you to unlock the next level of exercises. This is the case, for example, for TypeScript. In the third and most elaborate tier, Exorcism offers a learning graph, which looks something like this. Within the graph, you unlock different concepts. The graph depends on the language. For example, in JavaScript, you first unlock strings, booleans, and numbers, and then conditions, operators, and arrays. But each language is different. It's worth mentioning here, like I've said before, that a lot of exercises are repeated across tracks. So once you've mastered the logic, it's just a case of mastering the syntax of the language. Finally, Exorcism also provides a command line interface or CLI tool and a VS Code extension, which allow you to download the exercise locally, to test it, and to submit it. Just be sure for each track to follow the instructions to install the language and the testing framework locally. Exorcism also has rich gamification features with points, badges, levels, challenges, and a profile page. Now that brings me to the final feature of Exorcism that I wanted to point out, since you can also ask to have your code reviewed by a human. And of course, you can also review other people's code, although to do so, you first need to accumulate 20 points. Once you've started mentoring other people, you're probably ripe for the next phase of the learning rocket, of the learning journey. So let's talk about Codecrafters. As I've mentioned, Codecrafters has a number of things in common with Exorcism, like unit test validation, community, gamification. They support fewer languages and they have fewer challenges, but these challenges are more advanced and explore concepts that are worth learning independently. So far, I've finished the Code Redis with Go, and I'm nearing the finish line of the Code Docker with Go. As you might have guessed from the two examples, the challenges use the build this technology with that language formula. At the moment, Codecrafters fully supports Python, Go, and Rust. In those, you can code your own version of Redis, of Git, of Docker, of SQLite, and grep. Codecrafters provide challenges in 11 other languages with varying levels of support. For example, Nim only has the build your own Docker challenge, and JavaScript has the build your own Redis and build your own SQLite challenges. This means that you can choose to learn a new technology using a language you already know, or a new language with a technology you already know, or both together, although I'm not sure that's wise. In my case, coding Redis with Go helped me better understand Go's Go routine feature, and coding Docker with Go helped me understand how Docker works. Codecrafters also has a specific CLI which can be used to run the tests locally, or rather, it runs the tests remotely using your local code. To download and submit the code, however, you use a tool that every developer should know, Git. When you push your suggested solution to an exercise, the service runs unit tests to test your work. These tell you if you've failed or whether you've succeeded and can push on. Codecrafters also shows a number of badges to reward the progress, so that's less developed than for Exorcism. And more importantly, you can vote on the features that you'd like them to add. This takes the form of either new challenges, like building an HTTP server or a shell, or extending existing challenges, like adding transactions to Redis or volumes to Docker. Now, going through the challenges was enlightening, both for the specific language that I was using and the technology that I was coding. It's a great way to gain a deep understanding of how the technologies and the languages work. And if you're interested in following the same journey and going deep, I've provided a link in the description. And if you want to keep exploring the developer's journey, well, I'll see you in this video.